This short video is on DC simulation. I'll cover the controller setup, some of the sources, how to annotate the DC values on your schematic, and other things such as sweeping voltages and temperatures, saving DC files, and other miscellaneous information. This simple circuit demonstrates the basics of DC simulation. Notice from the DC simulation palette I've inserted the controller. Then you run the simulation, simply click the icon or use the simulate command here, also the F7 key, and when it runs, you'll get the currents and voltages. Now because you only need to insert the controller and run the analysis, no setup is required unless you want to sweep some variable. Let's look at the results now. Once the simulation runs, you'll see the status window appear. Then you can go to Simulate, Annotate DC Solution, and immediately you'll see the currents and voltages appear for every circuit that you run a DC simulation and annotate. In this case, we start here on the left looking at minus 10 milliamps. This minus really means that the current is leaving this point and going in this direction. For the voltages, you can see with 250 ohm resistors, we split 1 volt, and then we have 1 volt here and half a volt here. I've named this wire label here, or node name, using this command, and therefore I can get the output voltages here in the data set. And here in the data display, I've inserted a list. You can see that the data set, I've named it DC Basics, contains frequency, we know that's zero. It has the source current and the voltage. We saw the source current, 10 milliamps, and we know at V out we should have 500 millivolts. I simply added those, and then in the list here you can see the results. And because we have the V out node, that's why we get this in the data set. Now let's look at setting up a swept voltage. The first thing to do is assign a variable. So you insert the variable equation or var block. I typed in VCC equal 1 volt. So this is my variable and this is the assignment here. And then I went to the source, this voltage source here, VDC, and typed in VCC. Let me show you the frequency domain sources palette. This is where you get the voltage source. Simply insert it. You can get current sources and inject current. You can also run a DC simulation for circuits that have other controllers and other sources, and I'll show you that in a moment. Now let's set up the sweep. Edit the controller and you'll see the sweep tab has a place for the variable. So we type in VCC and we'll leave it at 1 to 10 with step size 1, or you could put in a number of points. Then go to the display tab and select sweep variable, start, stop, step. And if we apply this or click OK, you can see that it appears. So we've displayed this. And you may want to do it this way rather than simply type on the screen, because in the case of a swept variable, you need the quotes and it's automatically done for you when you simply type it in right here. Notice the parameters tab, like any of the controllers. This is the amount of information, the level of information written to the status window. So there's no need to set that to anything greater. If you have active devices and you want to get those voltages, then you can simply click brief or detailed and they'll be made available. We don't really need to output the solution at every step. This is very simple. And then here in the output tab, we could select specific node voltages, measurement equations, or branch currents from our schematic that we want sent to the data set. Because we don't have very many, we're not going to overburden our data set. But if you did want to do that, down below there is an add or remove button. You'd press that and then you can select all those items that would be in the schematic available for the data set and remove what you didn't want. And then in the display tab, we can select those items that we want displayed on the screen, and all of the parameters for the analysis are shown here. And so that covers our setup for the DC analysis. Let's go back to schematic and then let's run this simulation and look at the results. Well, here are the results. I've inserted a new list, and for this data set, DC Basics, I'm going to plot only V out and the current. The reason I'm not going to plot VCC is because as a swept variable, current and voltage will be dependent upon that. Click OK, and you can see that here. We have our current, and it's dependent upon the swept voltage, and we have at the Vout wire label or node also the voltage, which is dependent upon the swept variable. So that's how you set up a swept variable, sweeping the voltage for a DC analysis. And going to the frequency domain sources, you can see this is where I inserted the DC source, or you can insert current sources, and they have their own parameters. You can see that here. Let's look now at a more complex circuit, and I'll show you some more interesting things about DC simulation. Here in the ADS main window, I'm using the icon for viewing the examples directory. I'm going into the RF board folder, and scrolling down, I'm going to get this mixer pager project and copy it into my directory. I've already done it. You can see that here. C users default, mixer pager project. And then we're going to be looking at the network, which is the schematic, the bias point design. Anytime you want to search for something, you can use this other icon, type in a keyword, and then you can get that particular design or project. But let's look at our bias point design for the mixer pager right now. Keep in mind, this is an older project, but it still demonstrates everything we want to learn about this aspect of DC simulation. Here you see a sweep setup for the DC analysis with a current source. Just like we set the sweep up for voltage, we set the current to be some value at a variable IBB, and then sweep it over a range. To get the collector current that we desire, we insert a current probe, and that's in the probe items palette. You simply go to that palette and insert the current probe, and then you get the current at that point. What's nice about this design is it shows we can sweep the current to select a current that we want and then calculate the resistors that would be needed. So I suggest looking at this for an example of sweeping current for a target value of collector current in this case. Now let me show you how you'd sweep temperature to conclude our short video on DC simulation. Open the DC simulation controller and set the parameter to sweep to temp, as I'm showing here. Simply type it in, lowercase temp, and then set your range, in this case from minus 20 to 90, step size of 10, and then run the analysis. And when you do, the data set will be available, and you'll get the temperature swept, and then you can look at all the currents and voltages for this value of swept temperature. And that's how easy it is to do. And this concludes our short video on DC simulation in ADS.